Hello, what is up, guys? This is B-Run, getting ready for another stream. So, we've got some cool stuff to go over tonight. I did some work on the Magic update, and it's coming together. It's coming together. Everything is done as far as the battle is concerned. it's just a matter of like making actual spells to stick in there. And I made a post on the forum about whether we want to make something that is flexible but requires work on the part of the people using it, or make something that's a little bit more plug and play, where basically I have it all set up for you and then maybe you can change the specifics of each spell that I put in there, but you're more or less locked into like what's black magic, what's white and or gray. So there's that. I might try to release a patch for both. but yeah, it's coming along. And so that hopefully that'll be done here in the next week or so. But other than that, how are you guys doing? I've had a little bit of a busy week. Work's been a little bit busy, but good. Yeah. So let me know how you guys are doing, and we are going to get into this. I've got Discord up here, which admittedly I have not been in Discord as much as I had purposed to be this week. I'm gonna go ahead and close that for now and open up what you call it. What am I doing again? I don't even remember. Children of Vector, other hacking, Magic 2.0, and that one. Are you in? Okay, good. We're in good shape. We are in good shape. Now, I think I moved everything from my laptop over here correctly so that I can just... Yes. Okay. Good, good, good. Now, you guys got to let me know. Hey, Mog. How you doing? Ah. The fan. You know... It's funny that you say that. It's funny that you say that because my wife streams also, and the fan in the background has become a thing apparently on her stream also. Whoop whoop, that's right. Party, we're raising the roof or something. I don't know. Whatever people say. And things. And things. All right. So real quick, I'm gonna bring my hex over here, so we can see the addresses. I'm not going to go too in-depth with this, but I want to make sure that I have the proper... Yeah, so this is where I actually have it set right now so that everything is learned. But just to show this off, I'm going to go 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think that's all of them. 8E. Yeah. I think that's all of the ones. So she should, so Terra right now should have no magic.
Troller.
All right. So she's got Rama equipped and I need a breakpoint at, shoot. I don't know where my breakpoint is. Magic 2.0. Alright, and I want, yeah, this, I don't think this is the updated one. Is it? It is. Yeah, it is. I'm in the right place. Okay. I need to find the post-battle script, because I need to stop at a certain point to make sure I'm getting the correct amount of AP. Hey, Guinea Tech! Whoa! 12-hour day. I do not envy you. Now, is this for your company? Or are you doing work for someone else right now? Because I know you were trying to get like your company back moving again, so I'm not sure which one of these two things that is. Hopefully it's for you. So if it's for you, then that's a good thing that you're getting a lot of work. Alright, post-battle script. Alright, I just need to find... This is where I'm going to pause it. That's where I'm going to pause it. Move this up. Ah! Come on. C2, 6, 5, something. No, 5E, 6E. 5E, 6E. Alright, execute, okay. And 00FB is what the, what that's gonna be. Okay, cool. Well, can't complain with that. That is good stuff. That is fantastic. Ah, I get up early every morning. It's not that big a deal. So, she currently has nothing. I erased all of her stuff. This is a perfect save, so everybody has dog block. She's punched that bird to death. Okay, here we are. Alright, so I stopped here so that I could, I'm just gonna give her, 100 AP so that she learns all the spells. 1A6E. Alright, so she has Rama, which this right here is going to be the amount of, the amount of AP on the Esper, and then her, learned spell bits are over here. And so she should be learning 3 spells, 3 bits, and getting 64 set right here. Alright, so let's run. Yep, 100 magic points. She learns Bolt. Bolt 2, and look, we have, look up here. So we've got C64 here, and look, it's set learning Bolt and Bolt 2. 80 and 80, or, you know, bit 7 and bit, what's that, bit 2 or 3 or something like that. And then it's going to learn one more also, and so you're going to see this 84 change one more time to 8C, so she learned Poison. So that's it, setting the bits there as it's going around. Nice. Man, I can't wait till I'm old and I can, like, just ask for stuff and expect to get it because I'm old and people are like, okay, I'm just... Don't tell me any more stories. Alright, so as you can see, it's working. So that much is working. Battle's working. And I'm gonna do one other thing here. Actually, I'm not... Do I want to show that off? Maybe I'll show it off. Am I in the right stuff? I am not in the right one. I actually want to be using one in one drive. Man, I got too many folders and subfolders and then folders of subfolders, and it takes me forever to find stuff sometimes. Especially when I'm streaming and I'm, like, concentrating on talking and then concentrating on doing this at the same time. They don't mesh. Alright, so this is the way that you're going to add spells in FF3 USME once this is set up. Now, currently, I've got it set up to use some spells. It's using the old Desperation attacks as the spells, and I've already renamed them and done a little bit of work on them, but not too much. But what we're actually going to do when you're setting them, however, is you actually don't set them like this here. And so you see that I have Fire 4, Ice 4, Bolt 4, Drain 2, Flood, Blink, Blink, Blind, Blink, Morph, and Wall, and Renew. All these spells that I came up with or whatever. We're actually not going to set these. Because what we're using, what it's actually looking for is these here. Okay, so what we're using is what the offset is for these, and then it gets mapped to this. Okay, because we're using the same thing here. It has to use an absolute number to find what it's learned. We don't have huge gaps. My audio is clipping. You know, someone said something about that the other day, too. I am not sure what to do about that. That might be something I have to look into. Of course it did that. Why wouldn't it do that? I was really hoping Windows 10 wasn't going to do that with SNS9X. Alright, well, I'll have to look into that this week, then, if my audio is going to keep having problems. I don't have another mic, so this is it. I mean, I could switch to the built-in mic on the camera, but I do not know that that would do me much good. So we'll if this is making it hard for you to understand and follow, let me know. Actually, you know what? I've been following Windows 10 since it was in the preview build, and I've been doing stuff with it, and for the most part, it's actually run really well. It's actually been head and shoulders better than 7 or 8. So I will say that. Anyway, so we're using these, and it's basically using a value here to find the actual spill number. Okay, so we're going straight from 335 to 36, 37, 38. That's what the slots are. Alright, so if we're adding something in here, what we're going to add, so hypothetically, if we want to add Fire 4 here, which is the first new spell, and is our F0 is the actual spell number. What we need to add on the Esper side is actually Rama. Okay, because this is the next one. This is slot 3-6. So 3-6 here, when you get to where that spot would be, it is F0. Okay. Let me check my audio real quick. I'm going to switch it to
this. And, oh boy, that's jumping a lot. Does this work any better, or is this super loud? It looks like it's jumping a ton. I can turn that down. So let me know, does this sound any better? It's further away, because this is the microphone that's built into the camera. So if that's any better, I'll stick with this. If not, I'll change it back to my my normal mic. I've got this USB hub, and everything that gets plugged into it doesn't quite work well enough. Sounds like a vacant house. That's better. All right, well, I'll stick with this then. I'll stick with this for now. I think what I need to do is I just need to plug everything into the actual computer rather than using this USB hub, or I need to get a better USB hub. I don't know. But everything that gets plugged into this stops working on some level. In fact, I literally just had to move my mouse to being plugged into the actual tower because it would just stop working. And so we think it's the USB hub that we've got, which sucks because we spent like $50 on it. Okay, anyway. Like I was saying. Anyway, so what we're going to do here is we're going to add Rama. And we're going to add... I don't care, Toronto. All right. And what we're going to find here is that when we run it this way, and I want the same breakpoint I just had, which was what, 2E665? I don't know. I don't know. Magic points gained for battle. 5E6E. Go away. Did I save that? I hope I saved that. Dagnabbit. I have a strangest feeling I didn't save that. Okay, I did. Good. Alright, so 5E6E. And show hex. Bring that back over here. You guys probably can't see the hex anyway, but you should at least see that I'm doing something. And, alright. You know, that's actually a good idea. I've been, like, learning a lot recently to just, like, speak up and say things. So maybe I actually need to do that. Because if I cause a fuss, something will happen. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to set this for 64 again. And now you notice that we set Rama and Torado as the spells that in FF3 USME, what it thought the Espers were actually doing there. But what's gonna... Oh, shoot. I forgot to fix some... Hold on. Hold on. 1A6E. Let's do that again. I forgot to turn that back off. I forgot to turn my learned spells back off. But yeah, dealing with Comcast, dealing with everyone else. Like, I've been learning that I can actually... I actually have rights, and I can, like, not cause a fuss or make a scene, but I can be firm. That is okay for me to do. And I can actually get things, because I am owed things if people do not hold up their end of a contract. For my entire life, I've always been the kind of person that's kind of like, okay, I don't really want to cause an issue, like, I get that this isn't entirely their fault, they can't really control it, all this other stuff. But, ultimately... You know, just do that. But, ultimately, I should be expecting certain things when people are saying they're going to give me a service. So, if I buy something, I should be able to expect something from that. Yeah. No, you are absolutely right. You are absolutely right. So I've been learning in the last, like, year or two that I can actually speak up on this stuff and not be, like, embarrassed to do so. All right, so we set Torado and Rama as what we were learning here. So it was bolt to poison. Oh, WTF. I must not have, All right, the OneDrive copy, maybe. You know what? I probably didn't load the OneDrive copy. I didn't. I loaded the wrong copy of the game. I've been having trouble with transferring all my stuff. I mean, not trouble, but, like, keeping track of which things are supposed to be which things. Wow. All right. So FB, set range, and breakpoints at C25E6E. I'm going to have this memorized. Run F1. Let me make sure that that breakpoint actually stays. Oh, wait. One more thing I got to do. 1A6E. Make sure I zero all this stuff out. Why does it say 7-1? Is that really where it's... Shouldn't that be 7-E? Is the, You know what? I don't care. 00FB. Alright, I think I got all the things. Oh man, the broken 360s. Yeah. Yeah, Red Ring of Death. But if you pay for something, you're supposed to get it. I bet my money wasn't defective. Alright. Shoot. Alright. 64. And you know what? I'm going to make sure, just in case, that I did change that. Okay. Good. Alright. Now! Hopefully this time we got it. Poison and learned Fire 4. And there's a gap there, and I need to fix that. It's a minor thing. I just have to change one little thing about the way it displays for things that are not from the original magic list. So, but that's, for all intents and purposes, that's minor. Alright, so it says to learn the spells. And then we can test to make sure that they exist. They are indeed learned. 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 I learned it. Yep, there it is. Fire, Fire 4, and Flood. Which, incidentally, I did not create... I had started an animation for this, but I actually didn't do it. It just sits there for a long time and then does the... It's supposed to be just like a full screen thing. And so I haven't actually added the startup animations yet, but I already know where that is. It's actually not a hard thing to... It's actually not a hard thing to fix. Alright. And so... Oh, I don't need to... I don't need the breakpoint anymore. Alright. And so let me go back over here. And so I just relearned all the spells by changing the spell learned bits all to FF, or bytes to FF. And so you can see all the spells. Alright, and currently the new spells all appear at the bottom and will always appear at the bottom. But again, I already have a fix for that. It was just trying to figure out whether I wanted to put that fix in automatically or make it more flexible where I show people how to do it and then they can do it because they'll want to make their own spells or set it for their own, you know, because not everyone's going to use the desperation attacks. Maybe they want to leave the desperation attacks in. Maybe they want to make it so that they can use, you know, summons through this. And so they'll pick 10 summons that they want to do, you know, in which case the summons already have their own startup animation and would be okay just appearing at the end. It doesn't have to blend into the rest of this. So that's kind of what I was debating on today. And then there's like one other minor thing, which you probably won't even notice. Can I get my mouse over here? So these arrows right here are actually supposed to stop just a little bit higher than this. But I don't think anyone's going to really notice this. I'm not sure where the code is for this. When I did Trance, it was replacing Rage. But the menu doesn't scroll for Trance, and so I wanted to get rid of those little carrots. But I can't find it. So the little carrots are just always there up top. Like, there's a whole list there, but you can't access it. So I didn't find that before. I haven't looked for it this time around either. But this is where I'm at in the magic. I have not done the C3 stuff. I've not done like the menu access, and I've not done the little bit of work that's in C0, which is this little thing right here. I'm sure nobody's going to notice that. Like, and it even still looks like it's fitting on there. It's not like it's going off the screen or anything like that. So no one's going to notice that. But yeah, so I've made space. The menu knows how to see all of the spells. All the spells are there. It's just a matter of making them filter into the list where I want them to go, which is fine. It's not that hard. So really just small little things left to do. That's where I'm at there. And I do some more stuff with this right now, but I don't really feel like it. Actually, do you guys have any preferences? I put the question out there on the forum today about what people enjoy when they're watching my stream. I'm assuming you enjoy something because more than one of you has come back. Like, most of you that are here have been here for more than one stream, and so there must be something that is bringing you back. And so I'd like to know what that is. Like, what thing can I improve on? What thing should I be doing more of? Like, are there certain things that you enjoy watching more? Now, I'll probably do, you know, this is kind of an eclectic kind of hacking thing, so it's not going to be the same topic every time, but I want to know what it is that you guys are, like, most excited about. Like, if you see on the forum that I'm doing something, does it, like, pique your interest? Is there something you're like, oh, well, I want to make sure I catch this stream, versus, like, I don't really care so much about that. That's fine. So let me know what you, Mog, you enjoy the hex? Well, that's good. That's good, because I can definitely do Hex. So yeah. Oh, that's so nice. Thank you, Mike. All right. I enjoy seeing you too. I should probably make sure I say that. It's like the person says, I love you, and you're like, thank you. So I want you to know, I enjoy seeing you here, too. All right, actually, I kind of want to go in and look at some of the You mean when you're not busy, like, sleeping and stuff? It's like the middle of the night for you. I do not judge any of the Europeans that do not stop in every single stream. Exactly. Exactly. So I'm going to show you some of the stuff that we had. Did I really have copies of all that stuff in here? Maybe those are edited. I don't know. It's been a while since I looked at this stuff. This is what we got. I should be able to just zoom in. I shouldn't have to do this. So this was the old Iris sprite sheet, which we actually don't have the same limitations any longer. So for those who weren't here, because I don't think Mog was here when we did the first 15th man project, when we started it. I don't think Funky was either. But James and Mike were both there. And like Tenka and Kyuga, I think, were all around. I think this is when they had like just started on the site that we were working on this. So this is Iris Havengard. Iris is her name. And she was experimented on, and she's like got a half deformed face, or like demon-esque face. So I don't know how many of you have actually seen this before. This sprite was designed by Lord Sudabeno. I don't know if I'm saying that right. I think. Oh, you were? Okay, I wasn't sure. I thought your name was new when I came back to the site, but apparently not. So, sorry. But yeah, so this is the sprite we came up with, and we actually don't have the same spriting limitations. We can actually use any 12 colors. We've got two ways to work around that. We've got that. We've got a portrait that is based off of Terra's portrait, but doesn't look enough like it that it spoils this portrait. And I really like how the face is, like, marred. And then I've got, like, a bunch of notes. So we actually have certain things in here, and I don't know if I have any save states. I probably actually don't have any save states for this. In fact, I'm willing to bet I've got nothing. Yeah. What I do have, though, is if I can open this in... Now, last time I ran ZSNES, the first time I ran ZSNES on Windows 10, it crashed. So I do not know that it is going to work properly. I think ZSNES is not here. It is in another folder of mine. Let's go here. Okay. I do not know that this is going to run, but I'm going to try. So let's hit Children of Vector. Because this will have all the proper saves and stuff. Yeah. All right, so currently I've got nobody in the party, and I created a tiny little event here that puts her in the party and plays her song, and I'm gonna listen to it. Oh, hey, it's not playing the song, is it? Oh, there we go, I had to move again. So this was the song that we used, and Geen Attack picked it out. I can't remember. I mean, it was all voted on. This whole process was voted on by users. It's from another game, though. And I expanded the sprite, the portrait. Now I have a dummy portrait in there, and I did not expand the palette. And I did not expand the palettes yet, but proof of concept. This is an extra portrait that gets added in there. So we have Iris, she loads. And she actually has a broken magic list currently. This is one of the broken magic lists. If you force magic on a character and it just reads the RAM that's around it, But that's actually going to be a non-issue when we come back because of my magic update. So her story... I put her up front. But she works in battle. Where we were at was actually doing the background ASM work, of course, for this. Kellethan, that's right. Yeah, from EverQuest. Okay, there you go. It is. And I'm going to try to find her story and read it. But she appears and works in battle, which again, this is an expanded sprite, expanded sprite sheet stuff. But works just fine. I gave her health, apparently, for now. Yeah, that doesn't do very much. So, all that stuff works. All that stuff works. I actually wish I had more to show off here. Let's go in here. Because it's all still in here, and I probably need to make sure I go back and save it. If it were at some point to get lost. Dead community project. Okay. Alright. Let's go to theme music submissions, because this should have... Yeah, this should have the information that I'm looking for in it. Okay, so first we had our concept, and we came up with the implacable experiment. So this character is an individual who has close contact with the Empire after being used for human or Esper experimentation in the Magitek facility and has taken on a grotesque appearance. The character is aware of their disturbing appearance, and their primary drive is to seek vengeance against those who have wronged him or her to see that they are brought to justice. This character would work well in FF6, as they would serve to show the more cruel and inhumane side of the Gestalian Empire, especially when you consider how much Terra's past is lacking in filling in the darker parts of the Empire's history. This character would also ideally have a somewhat strange fighting style and would vary from other characters. They also, by merit of being a Magitek experiment, could have natural magic learning list. All right, and so then the background that we came up with from this concept. So the backstory is the daughter of South Figaro Sailor, who was raised by a lonely old woman from Vector after the boat transporting her and her father sunk near the southern continent. She was then taken prisoner by the Empire in her teenage years after the old woman died and that Emperor Gestal adopted a secret law to capture homeless and unwanted citizens for Magitek experimentation. During her captivity, she developed her hate for the Empire that she was considering once her second home. Possible encounters. She might have contact with Sandan or Kefka, so this is where she might interact with the party. She might also have been in contact with some of the Espers and talk to them. It all depends on how we want to develop her backstory in game events. So, rich backstory with relations with actual characters in the game if we want. And explains well why the character feels doubly betrayed by the Empire and explains her hard trade. Might require a lot of event creation. Well, that's kind of the point. So yeah, so that was actually, then we had a bunch of, so this whole process, the way we did this was that we just kind of, I opened up a thread to submissions for concept, and everyone put in a whole bunch of concepts, and then we did a voting poll. So everything we did, we had like a preliminary poll where people were just like throwing plugs out for ones that they liked. And then the top ones would go to an actual poll here. And so that was basically how we worked out every aspect of the character. Now, where we got a little bit rocky, and I wish I had pushed a little harder on this. I wish I had pushed a little bit harder on this, because Fuse turned out to just be really not very possible. Fuse was the ability we came up with for her. Preliminary voting. Special ability poll. Unfortunately, my ability was in the running and second place, and so I couldn't, like... I didn't want to take over, because I wanted this to be a community project. And two, when you're in second place, you can't really be, like, poking the first place. Like, it just makes me look petty, you know, if I do something like that. But Fuse just turned out to not work very well. The idea was that she was supposed to fuse with an Esper, and then she would get, like, special abilities based on what, what she would do. Like, she would get specific abilities that she would be able to use based on which fuse she was doing. But the problem was, it was supposed to, I don't know. So it was supposed to use, like, a second menu, kind of like Control did. But it would use the Esper. But they also wanted it to give her a bunch of statuses and change the way she looked. And that was kind of the main one. They wanted her to, like, actually visually fuse with the Espers. And so we didn't really have, like, a good startup kind of thing, I think, on what Esper's equipped. That was probably up in the air. And so there were a couple, ideas. It was just, like, it turned out to be a little bit of a bear when we worked on it. We just couldn't quite get it down, and a few of the coders kind of dropped off, and it started becoming a thing where I was going to have to do everything. And that was not working. That was just not working for me. It's just, like, that's so impractical. Yeah, exactly. It's very difficult to do. And doing, like, a kind of startup animation for it would be tough. And so, like, my first thought was maybe it does, like, the Esper's attack. And then it would change. But then doing something to change your sprite just doesn't work very well. And so then maybe instead of doing fuse, like, you would select fuse and it would just go to a second menu with abilities that are populated by the Esper. And then the last part to this was that since all these abilities are set by the Esper, that is, like, what is it, 26, 27 Espers or something like that? Times however many abilities is, like, a ton of freaking new abilities to come up with. Well, sort of. I don't think it was supposed to be automatic. Although, an automatic kind of set would be a lot easier to code. It'd be a lot easier to code. In fact, if I took Fuse and if I took my trance ability for L'Oreal and built that into Fuse so that she would use like an AI, and then we could pick abilities. Again, they would have to be abilities that already exist in the game, if we did it that way. So if we made it, like, trance-esque, we could do that. Hello, world! Did you write a program to tell us that, Lock Kirby, or are you just typing that? Anyway, yeah, so we're just kind of going over some of the old stuff from the old 15th Man project, since we're talking about picking it up again. But I would like to hear directly from the people here, because I'm not getting a lot of responses on the forum. I'm not getting a whole lot of responses on the forum. So are you guys more interested in starting, like, a new character from scratch? Or would you like to... I guess my idea right now is I would like it to be 15 and 16. Now that I've got magic worked out, everything else we do isn't that much more effort to make 16 than it is 15. The problem we had before was that I did not have this. I did not have magic worked out. And so we had to really scrape to get another magic list for Iris, which Great Shadows did a great job. He moved the chest bits to another location of RAM, because the chest bits come right after the magic list, and so there was enough room for another magic list. So we had gotten that worked out, but there was no way we were going to be able to do that for another one. So we were like trying really hard to make sure that we could get one character working before we did two. But at this point, I feel like we have the information and the know-how and the RAM that we need that we could do two characters. So the kind of the ideas would be to, one, complete Iris, and then two, make a second brand new character with the same process, only with the people we've got on the site now. Or we could do two brand new characters. Or we could do Iris and like a returning character, or like flesh out a character that already exists. Like turn Cid into a character. Like Cid would be the first character you pick up in the World of Ruin. or Siegfried, which would have issues just with naming. But so we could do, you know, Iris or a brand new character and a returning character. So it's just a matter of like what you guys think would be the most interesting to do. So we have one vote for Iris and a brand new character. I am cool with that. I like the process of coming up with stuff, and I would like to see more people, like, because I guess more people creatively involved. I liked watching Iris come about. I liked her story. I liked the concepts. I liked what people come up with and bouncing off of each other and working with stuff, because I think Iris turned out really freaking good. So seeing more of that makes me happy. It just makes me mesh as well with Final Fantasy VI. That's where the trick is. And so I think we did that with Iris. And so coming up with another character would be cool. So... But I would like to hear more. You know, other people that are in here. And I've got my window up over here, so I can see who's on now. And I don't even have to. And I can. Oh, you know what? That's right on top of my Oh no, it's not. It's not covering anything up. Really? Well, my mouse goes. Oh, that is really interesting. That was never a thing before. Sorry, I'm just playing with stuff over here. You see, I've got this over here. Now I'm moving this in front of my chat window. You see? My mouse shows up there, but it's not covering up the... That is really kind of neat. Sorry, I'm just amusing myself over here. Chime noise. You know what that probably is? I don't hear a chime. I don't hear a chime, but it's probably Discord. Are people chatting on Discord? Because that chimes. Let's quit Discord. Let me know if you keep... Oh, you know what? It might be just like sound effects and stuff on the... I don't know. I don't have my volume turned up very high. So if Windows is making sound effects, then I don't know. So that might be what it is. Oh. A feedback thing? Then I don't know. Then maybe that's from the microphone built into the camera. That might be from the microphone built into the camera, because we used that at one point before for something else a long time ago, and certain notes or certain like levels would like it would almost like pop. Pop's probably the wrong word, but yeah. I was thinking like the doom kind of noise that Windows makes from time to time. But yeah, if you're getting that popping, it's probably that microphone there. I will work out the microphone issues. I probably need to plug the mic directly into the... I don't know how many USB ports I have left on the computer, actually. Especially if I'm plugging in my mouse. The keyboard has two. And I've got a terabyte flash drive plugged in, and a controller, and the mouse. So mouse, controller, keyboard, flash drive, I mean, that leaves me no room for anything else. I think I've got at least one more. I don't know. I'm going to try to plug everything in just directly to the computer and see if that fixes my problem with all this stuff. Oh, and the webcam's plugged in up here. I wonder if that's why the webcam doesn't have the same... I've been having some quality issues with the webcam also. And I wonder if the hub's another... yeah. The hub's causing that also. All right, I need to figure out something to do. Because we actually kind of already went over stuff here that I wanted to go over. I could look more into the map editing. I just have not gotten my brain wrapped around it. I keep saying this every single week. I need to find someone to make maps for me. Is there anyone that would make maps? They'd be happy to make maps for me. Because that is proving to drive me insane. And that is the only thing stopping me from, like, continuing gung-ho on Children of Vector right now. Now, I mean, I am finishing up the magic update. Like, I've got other things to work on, so I have not stopped working. But yeah. In order for me to, like, really get going is I need to get some map stuff done. So, alright, I'll try to talk a little bit more like this. And this is how I will interact with you for the rest of the stream. I do hope that we no longer have audio issues while I talk to you on the stream today. Okay. All right, let's do some map editing. Let's give it a shot. Am I in the OneDrive? Okay, good. I am in OneDrive because that has my actual proper... Shoot. Problem is, I don't know which stinking copy of the ROM to use. What I'm going to use... the OneDrive copy, because that I actually do have access to on both sides. Ding. Hey, you know what? That was calm. You interpret it how you want. You interpret it how you choose to interpret it. But don't put your interpretation on me, okay? Is that a good size? That looks like a pretty decent size. So, got a spiffy new event editor from... Actually, you know what? This might actually be the wrong copy. Let me make sure. Entrance. Okay. Yeah, I believe this is the wrong one. Hold on. Oh, I didn't do it. I can't do map editing tonight. I actually do not have my, I do not have the right editor. I do not have the updated editor. Well, I guess I could... I guess I could work on stuff and then export it. Never mind. I'll work on it anyway. Am I too far off there? That's good. Good. So maybe I should just start working on the other map, the one that, like... Hex owns event edits. Don't stop the hex. Yeah, that's... I don't use anything else for event edits other than hex. And that is on the... Well, I would say that's on the horizon, but it's not really on the horizon. I would like it to be on the horizon, but it's just not. Alright, so this is what I'm going to do. I'm just going to start working on one in here, and then I can export it, because this is actually the wrong... I need to get organized. because I've got like a whole copy of all my folders on my laptop. I've got a whole copy of everything on my computer, and then I've got a partial copy on OneDrive of the stuff I'm trying to sync up. But Hex Education? All right. Hex Education it is. Hex is all about numbers. Pin that to the taskbar so I don't have to go looking for that again. All right. See a maps. I will get that down eventually. Like, seriously, of all the things that I've done and had the tools to do, like, this is what's going to stop me? No. No. Hex Education. All right, well, if I'm going to do Hex Education, then I'm going to go ahead and pull up... The one I want? No. This is the one I want. I'm going to go ahead and pull up the magic update. Because you can see, this is all the work that I've done on it so far. That's all. Nothing big. What I do need to do, though, is see if I can find someone that maybe might convert this to an .asm. Or I might have to learn it myself. But where I'm at right now is the next thing I would need to do is create another branch when it's setting up the magic list to change the order of the spells that have also gone in. Hex is also about bites and nibbles. And nibbles. All right. How to fit changes you want into the space you want. Yeah, I know, right? Because what you got to do, and I've had to do that quite a few times where, in fact, you can see in my C1 stuff up above C2, I did a bunch of things where, oh, hold on. There we go. Where it would normally just be loading stuff, I'm doing jumps. I'm doing long jumps. So this code right here sets up some numbers. I don't even know how to explain it. This is setting up numbers, so when it's figuring out the offset for... it needs to figure out the offset to find where the location of the name of the spell is, and then also the length of the spell name for how many letters to put in. And both of those have to be very specifically set, and I had to create some extra branch, you know, some extra things to set those up a specific way. And then change the offset for where it's looking for the spell name to account for the fact that since it's loading from a different location, it changes the number. It was just a lot of, like, figuring out what the number was and what I needed to change it to, and less so about finding the root cause for where it all was. Yeah. Yeah, so where I'm at now is I need to get copies of a bunch of things open. And I can open those from here. That's not an issue. SNS, Children of Vector, documentation. What I don't have are my newer notes, but that's fine. So let's open that. Let's open that. Yeah, well, that's the nice thing about event editing... you don't have to worry about long jumps and short jumps or whatever else. Everything's just a jump. As long as it's after CA, after the CA bank, after the CA bank, everything just works. Okay, so the portion that I'm looking at here is down here, right here. This is where it pulls up the magic order. And I don't know why I still have all those stars in there, because I already fixed all those branches. I already fixed all those branches when I coded it. Let's do that from here. But anyway, so what it does is it pulls up the spell number, and then it converts the spell number based on a table, which I don't think I copied the table here. The table is here-ish. So it's basically telling it how many bytes to offset each group of spells. So this is like for black magic, if this is the order, if healing attack effect is the order, then all of the black magic spells are going to get offset by 9. Okay, so that means they're going to move 9 bytes out. If it's going healing effect attack, it's moving 1e bytes out. So that means they're getting shifted in the list that far. If attack's first, obviously there's no shift. And so that's where they are here. All right, same thing for gray magic. And these F1s, these are negative numbers in hex. And so that's actually moving it to the other direction. Oh yeah, what kind of ones? Granted, I never did a ton of event stuff, but I don't remember anything that just didn't work. I don't remember anything that just didn't work in, but I don't know. I guess I didn't do that much. So anyway, so this is where all this is. And so what I need to do is find a way to filter in the new spells into this. And so my plan is not exactly to use this, although these bytes will have to change. I'm going to have to make like a separate one. So I've got a couple ways to go about doing this. I'm trying to figure out which one's best. So one of my ideas is to change this here, this is the actual spell table, to filter these in the proper locations, okay? Because when it's checking for these in the original, it's checking for the spell number because the spell number corresponds to where it's at in the list. There's never any discrepancy. But for mine, since I have different spell numbers, I had to change it so that I was looking for the index for where it's searching. So I changed it to Y instead of A. Now, one thing I can do, and for some reason this is making it hairy later, and I'm trying to remember why. So maybe if it doesn't, I'll just stick with it. But basically my idea is to filter these into the list here, where they would go. So black magic goes through, I don't know. We'll say black magic goes through 12. I don't know where it actually goes. And then if this is, you know, fire 4, ice 4, bolt 4, then the next ones in the list instead of 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5 are going to be F0, F1, F2. And then it'll continue on with gray magic. Okay? And so what that does is it doesn't move the spell in FF3 USME, the monsters still use them properly, and everything else. It just moves where they're located in the spell table. Oh, I remember. So the place where that gets a little bit, might get confusing for people is when you're setting up the espers in FF3 USME, because that means you're using the spell numbers for other spells, like we already displayed. For those of you who were here at the beginning of the stream, you may have seen when I was doing this, you're using an absolute number for setting up your spells, okay? Because this is where Rama technically would sit as 3-6, spot 3-6, but the spell that it should actually be loading is this here. Okay, so when you're in here, you're not setting the spell from here. You're setting the spell from in here. Okay, so where that might get confusing for people, if these filter in here, is that's going to change even more of these. In fact, it's going to change existing stuff where you need to change it to a new number. I can expect people to get used to doing this, but changing it here is like starting to like, I don't know. It's starting to mess with stuff that people already understand how to do and might get confusing. And I'm trying to make this as user-friendly as possible, but it's making it a little bit harder to code because it means now I have to create a total separate set of filters for how to sort these in, which isn't that bad, really. In the code, it actually goes through the original, okay, 1-8 is where black magic ends. Or was it 1-8? Is that it? Yeah. So 1-8, 2-D, and 3-6. 2-D is gray, and 3-6 is where the end of healing magic. But it already has this in here, and those are actually not compare anymore. Those are compare Y. Oops. That's what all those are now. Did I really not update this? That seems silly that I did not update this. Normally, I'm meticulous about my changes and documenting them as I do stuff. That makes me suspicious. It makes me suspicious. But there's no way it would work if it did it another way, because it would load up the spell number, and then it would immediately just, like, not know what to do with it, so... case word check. You know, I actually did not work with those. I did not have many instances where I used those, so so maybe that's something to do with it. Although, I will say that I'm sure you could get it working. It just might take some ASM work in C0. I don't know why it wouldn't work off the top of my head, but that could be a thing. Branch based on current case word requires the first 4 bits of the last byte to address the case word bits being checked. Hold on. I need to wrap my brain around that. The first 4 bits of the last byte in the command. So the first 4 bits to address the case word bits being checked. So it's saying in the case word, are you checking this one, or this one, or maybe these two? So whatever ones are on are the ones it's checking for. Like which direction you're facing, right? The north, south, east, west, 4 bits. But why wouldn't that work with... Oh, because of... C-A. Okay. Because CA, no, that doesn't make sense. Because CA, B, and C, at least one of those has to use the first 4 bits. Oh, no, no, oh, so you mean you're saying the last... The last 4. Doesn't C use one of the last 4? Or is C... It would only be the last 3. Right? Hold on. Programmer. So, like, hypothetically... You're talking about these 4 right here. but it's already using these. So which ones are you talking about? Because look, it's using bits all over the place. No. Explain this to me. We're going to work this out. See, this is the kind of stuff I like helping with. This is a thing that we can do. See, you guys got to bring more stuff like this to me. Yes, F is 4 bits. But C is 2 bits. So looking at this, what bits would it use? Oh, because it's based off of 0. Never mind. Okay, you're talking about an offset. All right. Okay, hold on. That does pose a problem. I will give you that. It means the farthest we have to jump, like if we're going to say F, so C, D, E, F. Three, A, B, C, well, whatever. It doesn't matter what this one is, really. Is those right there. And then hypothetically, you could even, if you have like hyper expanded. Well, maybe that's one to leave, but. Right. We could change the code. What we could do is, I think you can have up to 6 bytes, 6 parameter bytes in an event code. And so, I mean, it would require probably making a second one so that it wouldn't ruin all the ones that already exist. But hypothetically, we could make another command, which would be something for Madseer to do if he's going to do his stream tomorrow. I don't know if it'd be tomorrow, but I think, isn't Friday what most people voted for? He could add a case word check. He could add a case word check for something to work in expanded space. So actually, I don't need to be in here. You would have to create another code that uses an extra byte. Okay. So actually, we talked that one out. I didn't actually have to do anything. I understand what you're saying now, though. All right. So where I'm at in here. So it gets through here. And then what I did instead, yep. So what I did instead of it blanking it out or loading up FF or something like that, if it didn't find the spell, is it just loads the spell and then saves it in its current location, which means it doesn't get offset at all, which only happens for the stuff at the end of the list. But what I could do is create more branching stuff here, which would probably end up being a jump to another subroutine where I would have to do it, where I can filter in the spells that go in the list. In fact, the easiest way to probably do it is to, let me think about this. I'm trying to think about the easiest way. I could just make a small table. Oh, you made a naming way hack? Oh, please tell me about that. I'm sure you've seen that I have naming way now. In fact, most of you guys weren't here last week. Actually, I can open that up. I can open that up here. I did some work on naming way. This is naming way as he currently stands. That badass helped me make. Like, he would make stuff, and then I would tweak, and then he would make stuff, and then I would tweak. But there's no way I would have been able to come up with the basic size of the character and the ears. I would never have been able to do that without help. So I've got naming way. What do you mean new captions? For what? That could be potentially very handy. Oh, you mean new captions in the dialogue boxes? Hey, you can just click and it adds a new one? Yep. Yep, yep, yep. So no, tell me about... I don't want to go look for... Okay, actually, you know what? I'm going to look for it on stream, so... So there you go. Yes, you are. You are late, Mad. We're just going over stuff. You missed taking a look at Iris. You missed me showing off some of the stuff with the Magic 2.0 update that is in progress. Was that this one? No. Oh, anyway, heck. All right. So it just adds naming way, and then oh, that's gonna be a little bit loud. Oh, I see. So it's just like a renaming thing. Cool. Cool. Well, if you would like an update to that. So what's this naming way edition? Hold on. I'm just going to hang out and do this. Oh, wait, hold on. Oh, it's Final Fantasy IV. Never mind. Never mind. But yeah, so I've got a... I've got a naming way in the works for Children of Vector. I'm looking at this now up here, and I made the forehead crystal smaller, so it looked more like a forehead crystal and not like... I don't know, like a puff of hair coming out from underneath. But that little dip there is bugging me. It all connects it. I might make that, like, actual skin tone. But yeah, I'm going to flesh out most of this. I would like to get a riding sprite for him. I may only do a little bit. Because, honestly, he's not going to need too much. I might give him some, like, fun dialogue. Like, if you guys ever played... the Final Fantasy IV remake. In the Final Fantasy IV remake, he went through, because they couldn't do renaming because of all the voice acting. So what they did was they had him lose purpose, and then you run into him like a million times. He's always doing different stuff. And so I'm tinkering with the idea of doing something like that, where you can run into him and maybe he'll have his own kind of plot line that's going alongside. Because that would be fun. That'd be a fun thing to add. And the sprite turned out so good, it would be a shame to let it go to waste. Ah, gotcha. What is the delay tonight, by the way? I'm hoping less than a minute. I am hoping. Yeah, which you guys also missed a couple weeks ago was more work on Cirrus. So I added laughing and finger wag, which is somewhere. There it is. He's supposed to have his hand behind his back doing the finger wag. It's a little bit hard to tell. Sup, Jackamus? Good to see you. Glad you can make it. You see it before I talk? Really? How would you even know? You see stuff pop up on here before it pops up on your chat? We are doing great. You're doing fantastic. Fan-freaking-tastic. So Cirrus is mostly done. I would like to finish him up, but he's low priority. We're actually not going to see him for quite a long time. I need to get a portrait for him. I did find a picture, and it's the closest thing I've been able to find so far that could be adapted. It is not in good shape right off the bat. I think I saved it in here. This right here. I don't open it up in paint, I guess. So I could potentially use a variation on this, or I use this as a base, because it's got the hair brushed back and then this going forward. I mean, ideally I would like this in parts, but it's whatever. This is the closest thing I've been able to find. And then obviously the face would have to be reworked almost entirely to make it look more Amano-esque. But it would be a starting point because I just need something for, I have no idea what to use for his portrait. So I picked that up. We also spent some time, and I would like to hear what Mads here and Jackimus think about reviving the 15th Man project as a full party roster, and whether they want to complete Iris and do another new character or what they want to do. So far, the consensus is, you know what, I'm not even going to tell you, because people will be like, oh, you know what, that's fine. So I want to hear what you think. So you tell me, what would you like to see if we were to revive the 15th Man project? Would you like to see 16 characters? What would you like those characters to be? Would you like them to be Iris, a new character? Or there's also fleshing out existing characters? I would just call it the full party roster hack. Iris plus new. That's what everyone else is saying. Okay, cool. That is the general consensus. I just wanted to see if anyone had any other opinions. And we did do some discussion on maybe what we could do with Fuse to revamp it and make it a little bit more doable. No, General Leo is dead. He's dead forever. What we should do is get a resurrection potion, but then you don't actually use it on Leo, you use it on the bird and the solitary island. Oh man. Use a phoenix down. No, see, there's a very clear distinction between dead and wounded. Now they call it the dead status. They are actually just mortally wounded. They're just mortally wounded. I don't have anything better to do. I'm gonna, since I don't have a whole lot of time, I feel like this is gonna crash on me. Oh, I think I loaded two copies on accident. That's not the right one. That's not the right one. Let's do this. Where's my... I don't know. Leo is built to die, but it would make his death so much less meaningful if he just came back. And let's go ahead, get a couple party members. Oh yeah, Does anyone else have this problem with FF3 USME? Do you see the blinking? Why does that happen? That didn't used to happen, and I thought I had this problem with Children of Vector. And I was like, oh crap, what did I do? But then it actually happens on other things too. So is this just something that happens with SNES-9X? Because it doesn't happen on ZSNES. Yes, that was meaningful. Don't you say otherwise. Oops. Nah. I don't really care so much for Aerith. I was always kind of a Tifa guy myself. Tifa or Yuffie. And they both lived, because they weren't pansies. Alright, so let's, grab a couple characters. You know what I didn't test? It should work. But Go-Go should get all magic. Well, all the learned magic. Gal. That should be fine. Alright, show hex. 1A6E. And I need a lot more of these. I need a lot more of those. Fill out all the other lists. Oh man. I just cannot get behind Final Fantasy VII that much. I just couldn't get into Aerith. You know what? I don't know how far this goes off the top of my head, so I probably shouldn't go too far. Okay, probably down there. And I think I only need to get about this far before we're running into the extra bits. So let's go back up here. And we're going to test some stuff to make sure it works. Alright, so you can keep that. And then you can learn Shiva. And then Go-Go obviously has nothing. And then we learned that my breakpoint needed to be at C25E6E, I believe. And 00FB. Pandora the Explorer? Oh my goodness. What in the world? And I already fixed lures, so they all work. Because those get saved in the same list as the magic. So it was kind of a thing getting that to work. Yeah, I couldn't get into that. Alright, so we're just gonna learn all the spells. Go-Go gained a level. Zetsu gained a level. Learned Ice, Ice 2, Rasp, Osmos, Cure, Bolt 2, Poison, Fire 4, Flood. Oh right, because I changed those. So now when I go into battle. I never tested this, so whoops. Go-Go should have all that magic. Because I did give him... Basically, anyone who doesn't have a set list... WTF. What just happened? I might have something else to look into. Oh, you don't have magic! WTF! Oh, boy. I gotta look into something. I found a bug. I have a feeling I know what it is, too. I I liked FF7 at the time, but it's never been able to, like, give the same, I don't know, punch that Final Fantasy VI did. It never had the same impact to me. I don't really care about that anymore. I found a bug. And it has to do with when it's displaying stuff in lists. I had to set something to make sure that I had to make sure it knew I was in the magic list for it to change certain things that it displays. But you know what? That shouldn't happen there. This is interesting. I'm gonna have to check on that. Really? And why does it say you have slot? She's jacked up. Okay, look. Nothing should have happened. Oh! In this, check this out. Someone reversed magic and morph on this character. So that may not actually be my fault. I'm not entirely sure how that would happen, because that doesn't happen for other characters. Alright, well, I don't feel like doing that again. Yeah. No, that is not how it ended. But I commend you for not finishing it. Can they? Then that's something to be looked into. How do I do that then? How do I reverse it? What are you talking about? They're short. Okay. Isn't that the, Well, I'm learning new things today. Chant the magic word. I know, right? That's how it feels to me. Well, why are they reversed? Is there something I can do to reverse them? Is the game supposed to know it can reverse? You know, I need to get rid of that breakpoint. I don't want that right now. Okay, so it's on short, but now what? Is there another thing? Seriously. I changed it to short, but now what can I do? Seriously. To press A on the short options. When you're actually in the config menu. Oh my goodness. I didn't know this existed. So, I've been playing this game for 20 some odd years now. I had no idea this screen existed. And then when you undo it, did not know that was a thing. Huh. All right, so I'm going to have to do some experimentation and figure out exactly why it's doing that. I have an inkling. I have an inkling of something to check out. Fire 4! Yes, thank you, Odal! Yeah, I need to fix the startup animation there. Okay, good. I'm glad I'm not the only person who's been playing this game for so long and had no idea that that existed. Huh. Only when you're over there, huh? The thing is, like, after you're already on the short list, why does it matter what order they're in? Because everything is equally accessible. It's not like you have to go through the other stuff. Why that is. I had to change something that changed, Yeah, I don't know. I know, right? If it did something useful, it would be a cheat code. But I stand by the fact that it's not actually that useful. Gotta maybe get that to break again? Like, I'm not entirely sure what to do with that now. So there's this thing I had to do. Up here. But that should have only happened up here. Because this is where spell names are set. Basically, it's just checking, it's this right here. It's loading this 7BC2, which is used for a couple different things, but it's kind of tell you where you are when you're navigating. It's giving the C1 some information on where you are, so it knows stuff. Okay, and from what I was able to find, OD and OE are the ones that are the only ones that exist when you are in the magic list. And so the way I differentiated how it was knowing when to pull the spell name one way or another way for the stuff that's beyond the magic menu was to use that variable. And so it checks for OD and OE, and then if it doesn't find it, then it knows it's somewhere else, and then it does that. But this literally only runs for spell names and Esper name links. So that shouldn't cause a problem if the magic order, you know, if the spell menus are out of the way. Although it does use this 7B2C. It does use 7B2C when you're in that basic menu. But what it doesn't do is call any of this stuff where I actually utilize that. So, I don't know how that would have affected that, but that's the only thing I can think of that touches what is there. So, unless that is an actual bug that could have happened, I don't know. So, I'll look into that tomorrow, because that's a thing. Yeah, that's the thing. We have cursor memory. We have cursor memory, and we have the short menu where you are automatically where you need to be. Like, the only thing that changes, and this is an option that is specific for the short menu. Like, if they made it so you reordered the regular menu, that would make sense in my mind. But reordering the short menu where it's like this already doesn't make sense, because there's no process to go through. You just press the direction. So why rearrange those? I don't know. Preference, I guess. In your spell menu, press Y and it shows the MP cost next to them. I think I knew that one. I don't really use it, but I knew that was a thing. Hey, lady! Glad you made it into chat now that it's 11:06. Sorry you were having problems with that earlier. And we're just looking at some, Now, is that in the skills menu that you're talking about? Yeah, I don't know. In lurker mode. That's okay, I'm okay with lurker mode. Yeah, you don't mean here. You mean in the other magic list. Because this already has the MP right there. I wish I had set these up before the stream so I could just show off a couple animations. I actually already have one for Drain 2, because that's going to be in Children of Vector and Flood. And Morph, I think. I get to come up with a bunch of new spells for Children of Vector, actually. Now that I have this, I've got 10 new spells I get to add. I just got to figure out what I want to do with them. Well, that's exciting. We have to remember, back in the 90s, they expected you to read the manual that came with the book before you played a game. And I guarantee you, if you read the manual, that stuff's in there. The thing is, I created the names, but I didn't actually make them. Oh, wait. Hold on. Hey, if you want to see him, I can just... put him up here. Oh, they show the death of Leo in there? That's so lame. That's like such a spoiler. Oh my goodness. This is weird. This feels weird to me because I've been... what just happened? Uh-oh. My controller stopped working. Man, I'm just having all sorts of weird issues today. Alright, well, I'm just going to use the... up, left, down, right. B-A-Y-X. So you start, select, L-R, and up, left, up, right, down, right, down, left. No. Down, right, down, left. Down, right, down, left. Okay. No, I'm actually just frozen. Oh, come on. Man, I'm having just, like, navigation problems and all sorts of things today. I need to, like, nail this down. I love my new computer. I love my new computer to death. But I need to iron out some stuff. Game keeps freezing. Why does this keep freezing? Why are you doing this to me? Let me use... That's humongous. Man, I don't know. I do not even know. It does. It really does want us to die. It is not happy that we have come about. I don't know why. We are its makers. And yet... So Drain 2 is basically a Drain All. Without the some of the damage limitations. And Flood's just kind of cool. So you decided to make it look like it's just like a torrent of rain. Just like a torrent of rain. Because the only other animations that it's got are like Clean Sweep. And it just, like, I don't want bubbles in the spell Flood. I wanted something that looked like... I don't know, powerful. And I don't. You obviously can't do anything. Yeah, I don't have anything else in there. But yeah, Flood's probably my favorite. I really like the way that turned out because it looks almost like a hurricane, you know, with like the spinning. Yeah, it's like, it's from, Quasar? I believe it's from Quasar. Without the stones. And so I've gotta come up with some other ones. I am taking Ultima out for Children of Vector. I don't need anything that's that OP. Although the end game probably will be scaled up a bit. I don't want one spell to, like, take over all the spells. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want one spell to make all the other spells obsolete. H-Bomb is probably it's probably the explosions. The little explosions. And then obviously a recolor. I think I have a full screen blue tint also I had to do. I don't remember. But yeah, but I like the ones that I've got so far. Exactly. Exactly, the one spell. I mean, and seriously, who's ever played a Final Fantasy game that wasn't the case? So, maybe I'm stepping out of bounds by not having Ultima be the end-all be-all. Maybe I will keep Ultima and then just make it, like, super hard to get. It'll be, like, the Merton. It'll be the Merton of Children of Vector. I don't know. Since I've got the extra space for spells now, why not? Why not? Alright, I think that's where I'm going to cut it off. It's getting kind of late, and I've been really enjoying chatting with you guys. We didn't really do very much today. We just kind of talked about stuff and showed off some things, which is fine. I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. I'm going to try to come up with something to do, though, next week, hopefully. Have like a game plan going in and then get something done. Maybe I'll do it is past my bed. You know, it's like 2 hours after my bedtime. So you're joking, but it's true. But thank you guys so much for coming out. I enjoyed having you. I hope to see you guys soon. I hope to see you guys next week. And we will see you then. So stay tuned on the forums. And happy hacking. Good night, guys. I will talk to you.